Viewers, you're watching the Policy Times. I'm your host Akram, and we are here at the consulate of the Union of Comoros. It's a very interesting story. I was with him. I got the opportunity to discuss with him about half an hour on that. Imagine when a foreign country or a country represents someone who is not born in that particular country as an ambassador to serve a particular country, what kind of integrity, personality and achievements has to be that person should achieve. And we have Mr. K. L. Ganju, who is Ambassador, Excellency K. L. Ganju, who is the Honorary Consul General of Union of Comoros. Now, Union of Comoros is a four island nation in the African continent, and it's not a big country. It has a population of 7.5 lakhs, which our Excellency would describe and give us details about a bit about short brief about the country. Now, the country is rich with its own beauty, natural resources and all. Now, the most interesting part that I said, that when an Indian being nominated and given the honor to be the representative of a nation, what is an achievement of that? First, we would like to congratulate you, sir, for the excellent achievement. You are serving the Union of Comoros since last since 2005. First question I want to ask you, how would you describe the beauty and the opportunities of Comoros, Union of Comoros, to the people of India?
Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to talk about Comoros. In 2004, when I was asked that there is a possibility of me being appointed as Honorary Consul General of the Republic of Comoros, I was not very much knowing what this field is, but due to the pressure of my friends and all, I did go to that country. I was interviewed by the foreign minister. I was also interviewed by the president of the country. And they, in one interview, selected me and asked me, he is the right person for us to represent us in India. So in 2005, my gazette notification was done after due diligence. And I started assuming the charge of the Consul General. But when I assumed the charge of the Consul General, there were so many, you know, problems to be faced. What a Consul General is, what are his duties, what are his functions, how will he do it. So fortunately, I met an officer in the Ministry of External Affairs. He said, Mr. Ganju, if you really want to, you know, do something for that country, in that case, you must have a separate office as Consulate of the Union of Comoros, Honorary Consulate of the Union of Comoros in Delhi, and start functioning and start developing the bilateral relations between Comoros and India. I did the same what I was advised to do, and I also appointed in my office one retired officer who helped me to know what diplomacy is, who helped me who guided me in many ways that how we should proceed, and I'm thankful to that gentleman. Now he is not with me, nevertheless. When I became the Honorary Consul General, apart from the division which was heading East and South Africa, many of the people in the ministry never knew where Consulate of Comoros is in Delhi or where the country is in Indian Ocean, which was a big challenge for me. True. Then I started working, and today the situation is, you talk to anybody in the diplomatic circle, you talk to anybody in MEA, they will tell you, they will describe what Comoros is, they will tell you about me as the Consul General. There was a joke one day that we want a Consul General like Mr. Ganju. So another ambassador who is not in India now, he was ambassador of Mali. He told me we will have to clone Mr. Ganju to have another one like him. So people, but
excellent.
The situation today is that so many times my foreign minister has visited India. So many times delegation have come to India. There was not even one student from Comoros who was coming to India for education. Today I have more than 250 students, and especially Comoros is a Francophone country. English is not very popular in Comoros, but students come here, they learn the English language first and then join the college. And so many students have gone back, graduated and postgraduated. So I have got this opportunity to serve the people. So many patients are coming from Comoros to India now for treatment. And all the patients who come here are naturally serious patients because it is very expensive to travel from that place. Island country, airline tickets are always expensive than the, you know, otherwise things are moving in right direction, and very shortly the very high level delegation from India is going to Comoros, and which will be headed by the Vice President of India.
That's a great
I am person. Very happy about it. My country which I represent is eagerly waiting to give a rousing reception to the Vice President of India and his delegation. We hope to sign many MOUs because India today is a fast growing economy, so therefore everybody is looking towards India. So Comoros is also looking towards India for help and for their technology transfer and for their other, you know, help in the field of education, in the field of medical, in the field of sports and all.
Excellent.
Viewers, the first Consular General coming from the normally most of the countries, the ambassadors are chosen from the IFS category, like they are the government exam qualified officers. Excellency does not belong to that category. He is an honorary consular from that format, and he has written an excellent book. It's called The Golden Decade of 2005 to 2015, where he has shared his experience in that book. I would like to know that coming from that background, what it means to be a diplomat and representing a nation outside.
You see, it's a big honor to become an honorary consul general and represent a foreign country in India. Is a very big honor. There are two types of honorary consuls. There are countries who don't have an embassy in India, so therefore they appoint their honorary consul in Delhi. So that honorary consul or consul general, whatever position he gets, is directly representing that country. But there are other honorary consuls who are in other cities in India, they are representing their ambassadors. So we have a bigger role, more responsibilities on our shoulders. And more responsibility means more work.
Naturally.
So, if you really want to have a definitive impression on the people here in India and also on the people in that country, then you have to be ready to work for 24/7.
That's excellent.
And I have been doing this. Let me tell you, because of this, my dedication towards Comoros, even Ministry of External Affairs, Government of India respect me for that. Because they say that it also gives India, you know, in high esteems in that country, that one honorary consul of this nature is there, so others in India would be also of the same nature. Looking at my dedication and service to the nation, that is the Republic of the Union of Comoros, I have been decorated twice. And last time when I was decorated in 2016, I was raised to the level of commander, and which is the highest decoration of Comoros to be given to any civilian, and especially a non-Comorian. I am an Indian and got that decoration. It is a dream of anybody to have this decoration.
Excellent, and we congratulate you for this also. When I was going through the report, we saw some of the comments made by senior officials, like the minister, foreign minister, had shared good words of praises for you, that the country owes to you for the great relationship between India and Comoros. I also read one comment by one of the African ambassadors, and he was really impressed. He said that it is an honor to work with you as an ambassador. That kind of feedback or comments and appraisal came for Our Excellency. Now, coming to this bilateral relation between India and Comoros. India is a rising power in this fast transformative world. Comoros is a four island small nation in the African continent, and given the importance of Indian Ocean, because all the cargoes that goes from India to other countries, there is a tremendous significance for this small island for India's trade relation, not only with this country but also with the entire African continent and other part of the world. What are the areas you see that India can explore the brotherhood or friendship with Comoros to flourish together for shared benefits?
You see, firstly, let me clear it. Comoros was a four island nation, but after independence, one island nation is still not with us. We are three independent, which is making us Union of Comoros. We have a total area of nearly 2,800 square kilometers with a population of 750,000 people. We have a large diaspora, and 90% of that diaspora is in France. Comorian people are really, really very good people. They are liberal in their working, they are liberal in their eating, they are liberal in their you know, every sphere of life. But being a Islamic country, they are very particular about their religion, and which is a very good thing. Apart from being very particular about their religion, they are liberal also, and there are so many things which can be said about the people of that country. As far as the relationship between Comoros and India is concerned, up to 2005 it was minimal. But if you look at the situation today, Comoros is on the map of India. Comoros is definitely getting full support from India by way of line of credit, by way of medical facilities, by way of giving concession to the exports from Comoros to India in customs and all. There is a separate tariff for Comoros. Through your digital channel, I would rather appeal to the business community in India that take benefit of the reduced custom tariff on many, many items, which are more than 500. Certificate of origin will give you concession up to 10 to 15%, and which is a very big thing. Comoros is very rich in spices, especially we are very rich in cloves. We export tons and tons of cloves to different parts of the world, and lot of cloves are coming to India. We are the largest exporters of perfume oil. It is a flower called as ilang ilang. It's a white flower, and they take the extract of that flower and send it to the perfume companies around the world. It is said that the perfume which does not include the ilang ilang oil from Comoros cannot be the best perfume in the world. So every perfume producing company around the world, especially in Europe, US and UK, they import from Comoros this oil regularly. Apart from that, it's a 40% agriculture based economy. But as I told you, the energy is a big problem. With the help of the Government of India credit line, we are constructing 118 megawatt power plant, which hopefully will be ready by next March.
Excellent.
When that is operational, I think the energy problem will be reduced to some extent. Moreover, let me tell you, after the Prime Minister of India and President of France, you know, started the idea of having an international solar alliance, which is a, you know, which is now a reality. Comoros will also benefit from that. Government of India is ready to give credit line of millions of dollars for the establishment of solar energy in the country. So we will benefit from this, and I am very hopeful the delegation led by the Vice President, which is going to Comoros next month, will announce some grants and some line of credits, and from which the Republic of Comoros will benefit. As far as Comoros support to India is concerned, we have been supporting them in all international forums, be it United Nations, be it African Union, be it Indian Ocean, IORA, Indian Ocean Rim Association for Development and all. And our support to Comoros was announced by my president when he visited India last time, that the India must get the Security Council seat, and we have promised them our 100% support on this. Excellent. So whenever the chance arises and whenever the definitive decision is taken by the United Nations to include India in the Security Council, Comoros vote will be there for India. And not only for the Security Council, in other forums also, in other elections in the United Nations, 99.9% Comoros has been supported India's candidature. More especially the recent election of the judge in the International Court of Justice, Comoros was the first country to vote for India.
Excellent. So we had Excellency, the Consul General of Union of Comoros. Now, just to summarize what the Excellency said, I'm very proud and happy to say, Excellency, and sharing a stage with him. So 4-5 points coming clear. One is India at the business front. India can explore the spices, rise of spices business that is happening in Comoros. And we can explore the renewable energy business there. And for our trade through Indian Ocean Rim, Comoros play a very important and crucial role in that. The other important part is the Comoros stand with India when it comes to India's permanent membership at the United Nations Security Council. And so this was it. Thank you. Keep watching the Policy Times.